rest of the family.
Yeah.
Are you?
A bit.
A bit.
Yeah.
Beautiful book, The Grasses of South Australia.
Yeah.
Is your mother thinking of selling this?
I don't know.
Do you care?
Yeah.
How much? Or is it just as much as you, or just as little as you care about Freya's attitude?
Mm.
Because my mother was an individual of profound integrity, deep. You've got deep personalities and you've got shallow personalities.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, there's. She was deep emotionally,
mm-hmm.
and she was devoted to her children, and I was one of them.
Mm.
I had a loyalty from four darling angels. My mother's parents, just two, and my mother and my sister.
Mm-hmm.
My sister must have inherited my mother's depth.
Hmm.
Some people are shallow personalities.
Mm-hmm.
They don't care much about other human beings. My father turned out to be a money worshipper. He snubbed me because I didn't pay him back $200, Auntie Rita told me. And Auntie Rita, on her deathbed, said, "I never had the love of a man." And that I said that. To my daughter, Frances. And she was deeply upset because she was fond of Auntie Rita.
Hmm.
Well, that's because Auntie Rita decided to show her better side to my daughter Freya. But and I'm deeply upset at the alienation from Freya,
mm-hmm.
my darling daughter.
Yeah.
I'm deeply upset. I mean, I'm. I think about this when I'm alone in bed. That's mm. I'm not sleeping well.
Mm.
My health is suffering, and I don't deserve to be treated like this by your mother or by Freya.
Mm.
And you're going to have trouble for the rest of your life if you care. From Freya's attitude and her mongrel husband, Tom.
Mm.
And he's the wrong bloke for her. But if she doesn't realise it, if she's too shallow herself to recognise his shallowness, well, then that's another tragedy in my family.
Mm-hmm.
My darling first daughter, I've been told, by Christopher that she sometimes sleeps under bridges. And I grieve about that.
Mm.
She never had any children because she got pregnant once. Goodness knows to the who.
Mm-hmm.
And if she engage in a casual fuck like that, well, I mean, you can have your life ruined forever if you're a female. But if you're a bloke, you can just like it or lump it.
Yeah.
And your mother's attitude now is pretty hard to take because I don't deserve the contempt that I'm getting from her. All the troublemaking that she's causing with your children.
Mm.
And I could chuck the lot of you
mm-hmm.
out on the streets. Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, you bugger off. You go from here and there.
Mm.
But I've got too much respect. Too much love for all of my children. I'm not only responsible for. I'm not a shallow person. I'm a very deep person, deep emotionally.
Yeah.
Some people are not, apparently.
Mm-hmm.
And Wink is sort of. Taking the stick to me, calling me overbearing. Well, I mean, I think he's using the wrong word. I don't expect him to be to mean exactly what I think he means. But overbearing is a bumptious, bossy, egomaniacal type person. Well, I mean, he's got the wrong. His. Well, for a start, it's got something to do with alcoholism.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think you're going to be an alcoholic, but you're going to have to deal with alcoholic. I mean, you've been completely dependent upon your mother's maternal instinct, and of course, my appreciation of you and your talents, which. I don't think that you're not even treating yourself in the right way towards saving your own life. Really, you're obeying your instinct in terms of getting away from as far as possible from the great beast.
Hmm.
I dreamed of starting it. Well, maintaining an institution for human enlightenment to become more human, more decent, not to be dragged back to the gutter again. I mean, your mother's selling off my book collection is a pretty contemptuous and disgusting thing.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, she'll say, well, it wouldn't. I mean, I know what her arguments are going to be.
Oh, fucking hell.
We got this from Bronte Gribble.
Mm-hmm.
That's a classic. I mean, oh, God. You see, I know what your mother's arguments would be. I mean, are we going to need this?
Mm-hmm.
And if we don't need it, why can't we by the well, by who? The great beast.
Mm.
Which is the government. And the great beast is only developing because of the degeneration and the degeneracy of a large number of people on the democratic basis. Robin Hood. I've collected these books over many years, and they should be inspirational books. Lincoln too, which is for special people.
Mm-hmm.
I've been trying to work to elevate human nature, not degrade it.
Yeah.
And the quickest way of degrading it is with alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
These are problems that you're going to have longer than I will.
Yeah.
And it's a very sad, tragic thing to see.
Mm-hmm.
To see you and your talents dragged down.
Mm-hmm.
Just because you're dependent.
Mm-hmm.
Upon them. I was dependent upon my mother. Well, basically all of my life, really. I mean, she came to my rescue again and again and again. She never failed me.
Mm-hmm.
Now, did that make me strong or weaker? That strengthened. Well, I've never been a forceful personality, and for them to call me overbearing, which means forceful and bossy, but overbearing means, in my terms, egomaniacal.
Okay.
Well, I don't think, well, it may not mean that to Wink, but then again, he doesn't, he's only just really had the first experience being, he hasn't been independent on his own, because he's been supported by your mother, backing him up with, buying him a vehicle in the first place.
Mm-hmm.
Well, see, money corrupts people.
Yep.
It makes and it corrupts them if they are made to feel dependent upon it, and I think that to a certain degree your mother has bought Freya, but then again Freya's become an alcoholic and Tom's an alcoholic, and I think he definitely is the wrong type of person for her.
Mm-hmm.
She deserves better than him. He's a money worshiper, he's a power worshiper, and he's a builder's labourer. I mean, he's an opportunist, and he's the wrong bloke. And I'm deeply disturbed by her attitude, which has been exacerbated by your mother's evil propaganda. I mean, it is evil.
Mm-hmm.
For most of my life, I've not said the Lord's Prayer, but ever since Wink had that threat of not being with us, but being taken away, I've been saying the Lord's Prayer again, and I don't know whether I told you, but I've tried to tell you. I've recited the complete prayer. It's a very long one. It starts off with the Lord Prayer, and then it goes into another childhood prayer that I learnt in, well, when I was, I suppose, 10 or 11 or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Gentle Jesus, meek and mild. Yeah. Oh, that's actually a hymn.
Mm-hmm.
And it was written by John Wesley's brother. John Wesley was a Methodist, a dropout Church of England priest.
Mm-hmm.
In 200, 300 years ago. At least three. I'm not sure what century he was, but well, he was battling against the tyranny of the Catholic Church.
Mm-hmm.
And I had ancestors who became emperors. Well, your ancestors too.
Yeah.
Who rebelled against the Pope.
Mm-hmm.
The Emperor Frederick the Second.
Mm-hmm.
Have you read anything about him?
No.
Right. Well, it's a pity.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I've got a book which Christopher wanted.
Yeah.
And he said that I was going to give it to him. Well, I didn't promise it. While I was living in your mother's house, I need not have lived in your mother's house.
Mm-hmm.
I lived there to look after her for 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
And it wasn't. So she didn't buy me, as she seemed to have bought you children.
Mm-hmm.
But then again, that's just the way she thinks.
Mm-hmm.
And but then again, her personality changed. I mean, I'd swear that it changed after she had that shock,
yeah.
which she brought upon herself. By doing her usual stunt, but that's the way she was born.
Mm.
She was born autistic. She's never been diagnosed.
Mm-hmm.
And autistic people tend to do things just because they want to do them.
Mm-hmm.
They don't consider others.
Yeah.
So they are deficient some way in their personality.
Yeah.
Well, your mother has had three children.
Mm.
By me. But the fact that you're a genius, and the fact that I was a genius, it doesn't guarantee you a life. It doesn't guarantee you to survive.
Yeah.
The lesser personalities of the world, like Tom Hanstock.
Yeah.
And he's. Is an opportunist, he's another bloody money worshipper. Well, those two people in Freya's life have sort of tipped her over, and I mean, in converted turn to being an alcoholic,
mm-hmm.
I think, probably, possibly. Well, even an alcoholic to some degree shows a deficiency in personality. Well, the number of people in Australia, alcoholics, I mean, I had members of my family who made alcohol.
Mm.
Leo Buring. Well, I suppose his name was Leonard.
Yeah.
But the family used to call him Leo.
Mm.
I never met him because he lived in Sydney, and he wasn't very close to his cousin, my grandfather.
Mm-hmm.
And my grandfather, Buring, went to Prince Alfred College, and these these private colleges to just educate materialistic people. Power, they worship power and money.
Yeah.
A lot of them. So they don't contribute to the development of human personality.
Yeah.
We've got a few grasses growing here that are interesting.
Yeah.
Gracious me. Well, I mean, you. So my institution for the development of human nature and the institution for enlightenment.
Mm-hmm.
Well, how crazy can you be?
Yeah.
Wanting humans to be decent instead of ignorant nature, earth killing mongrels.
Yeah.
Well, it's just your mother's maternal instincts that are, she's got my support in protecting you,
mm-hmm.
but she hasn't protected Freya, and she's done what she can to help Wink, but he doesn't seem to be quite, I don't know, I mean, if he's developed the attitude, a bit of a slightly contemptuous attitude towards me, then that can only develop from there, because how the hell he developed it in the first place, I don't know. I mean, so I don't like your chances for survival unless you can develop a bit more fire,
mm-hmm.
of towards your own self-survival.
Yeah.
Otherwise, I think I'm just wasting my time. I mean, mm-hmm. I don't want to waste my time with anyone.
Yeah.
I'm working for human upliftment, mm-hmm. not to put them down.
Mm-hmm.
Well, your mother is working to put her own family down.
Mm.
And, I'm virtually supporting that by supporting her.
Yeah.
Well, I think that's a waste of a life. It's a waste of my life, really.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if I'd lose much. Or 90% of what I've got left of my life's work, really, if I were to institute the sale of this place and across the road, which I could do.
Yep.
It'd take me a year or two,
mm-hmm.
to do that. But I'm just feeling so pissed off with the shit that I'm getting from my mother and Freya.
Yep.
I mean, it's not doing you and Wink any good. If Wink can survive on his own, well, all well and good.
Mm-hmm.
So, good luck, Wink.
Mm-hmm.
Well, but you couldn't,
mm-hmm.
so far as I can see.
Yep.
You don't have that fire of, it's not resistance, it's not even material ambition. Well, it's spiritual ambition. It's wanting to see human beings behave better.
Yeah.
Instead of being just, well, worse than animals.
Mm.
I mean, can I have a look at that?
Yeah.
Going shopping?
A bit, yeah.
Oh dear, you said you were going to get me a couple of things.
Hmm.
Oh, how are they, any progress there? Do you need money?
No.
Well, what more do you need with the, what did you say that you were going to get, that you were in the process of getting?
A new phone.
A what?
A new phone.
New phone. Oh yes, yeah. That's right. Yes.
Yeah. That arrived a few days ago, but I haven't had a look at it yet, or I haven't set it up. So, but.
Well, as soon as you can do that, the better, because yeah. I need all the backup and support, because I'm not getting enough now.
Yeah.
I'm just getting upset and I'm losing sleep and I'm, yeah. I mean, as it is, I've got the same problem that the poor old King Chaz has got,
yeah.
Prostate worries.
Oh, yeah.
So I've got to get up at night, maybe once or twice. Well, I don't know whether that's going to get any better or worse.
Yeah.
I'm trying to take a herbal remedy called, I can't think what it's called anyway. But it, surprisingly, it was recommended, mentioned to me by Dr. Allen. Well, I mean, it's a bit unusual when you've got your ordinary orthodox medical doctor ever recommending herbal remedies for anything, isn't it?
Yeah.
herbal remedy, but they're in capsule form. They're not bloody cheap. They don't seem to have much of an effect, but I'm not even taking them regularly.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not. So how the alienation has happened with Freya, I don't know. I mean, I loved all of your children, and I want to see you developed up, not just, you know, be absorbed by the ordinary, average, ignorant, apathetic mongrels who don't care about the state of the world. I mean, the world is deteriorating very rapidly.
Yeah.
And all that the scientists are going to do is just work with the money bag politicians. Most of the scientists are for sale anyway.
Yeah.
And they're just going to work for the money makers, and they're just going to end up destroying all life on Earth.
Mm.
Which is a pretty shocking prospect, really.
Yeah.
Well, your mother steals my tools and treats me like shit. Gotta steal some of her sandpaper.
Yeah.
She went hungry. Looks like poo.
Yeah.
Well, that's what I'm faced with.
Mm.
As a family.
Yeah.
I'm not working for a shit family.
Yeah.
That's why I got rid of Laura.
Mm-hmm.
I'm working for there to be better human beings, not worse.
Yep.
Human enlightenment, not ignorance.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I can't fight this battle alone, Oscar.
Yeah.
Floor?
Yeah.
Is that needed there, do you know?
I don't think so.
Would want to steal their husband's tool to see. It's the autism that was never diagnosed.
Mm-hmm.
And your mother, and I entertained that for 10 years, basically.
Mm-hmm.
Over the 10 years that we were at Monmouth, I did virtually nothing towards I just concentrated on looking after your mother. She got pregnant once, but she had an abortion, so I'm glad in a way we didn't have a child.
Mm-hmm.
There, living in that shithole. Shocking, shocking people.
Yeah.
To talk about ignorant people.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. They were shockers.
Mm-hmm.
Not most of them.
Yeah.
Ironically enough, some of the best neighbours was a Muslim imam.
Mm.
I used to sling up, make sly jokes at Christianity. I mean, I didn't mind because I didn't take offence at them. Because I'm not. I mean, I suppose really, statistically speaking, there are more mongrel Christians than there are mongrel Muslims.
Yeah.
And they're mostly Roman Catholics of North and South America. Oh, God.
Yeah.
Because most of Christianity is being turned into a degenerate religion. I mean, the Pope hasn't cared much about the industrialists killing Mother Nature, because the Christianity took a wrong turn.
Yeah.
And it just became an ego promoter.
Yeah.
Oh dear. Oh well.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm sorry I never got the opportunity to sort of have more talks with you.
Yeah.
you seem to listen, but you don't make much contribution in response.
Yeah.
And it makes me wonder, well, just how much fight you've got in you.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you don't have much, well, you don't stand much of a chance of surviving, Oscar.
Mm-hmm.
Which is a bit tragic.
Yeah.
So how many sons have I got? 3 sons, 4 daughters. And all of my daughters have been alienated against me.
Yeah.
And the last one being Freya. And how the hell she got alienated? How or why? It's very tragic and sad. Michelle talks to me. I see her at these... She must have picked up a lot of my characteristics, traits, T-R-A-I-T-S, spelled, pronounced traits. Did you know that?
Yeah.
And she got pregnant, but Laura put her foot down. Said that it'll ruin you. Frances has got a good fighting spirit, but she doesn't respect me. She's had, 4 children, I think. Or 3. Do you know how many children Bran's got?
3?
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're all boys.
Yeah.
I suppose she's trying to have a daughter.
Yeah.
How to live without fear and worry.
Hmm. just for the record, the first question he asked before he came in the room was, well, what he said was, in typical fashion, for the umpteenth time, came in the room and said, I can't get the image of Freya, or I can't stop thinking about Freya. Well, he has to project it onto me. I don't know why he has to project, like, okay, you're thinking about Freya, that's worrying you. It doesn't worry me. And my answer to that, first of all, he said, he came in the room and he said, I can't stop thinking about Freya. I'm so worried about her and the way she's alienated herself from the family. And so he said, do you care? Which is, of course, a typical provocative question where he's trying to get a response out of me of some sort. And he's trying to rile me up or something. But the answer to that question, do I care? I said a bit, because I didn't want to say, no, I don't care. Like, I would have thought that would have been a bad look. He might have scrutinized me for that. So I said a bit, like, yeah, in my own way, or maybe, oh, yeah, a little bit or something, you know, just to get him off my case a little bit. But the real answer is I really don't care, because you can't change people. I mean, no one even bothered or tried to successfully change Hitler, did they? The only thing they did is either tried to change him unsuccessfully or tried to kill him unsuccessfully.
For the chickens, which I could have done on Coles, but I didn't shop, so I'll need to. That's too expensive that way. It's still doable, but I also need to try and get some garden stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's ridiculous. It's toil and toil and. The odds are stacked against you with everything you do, but you do it anyway. Oh, with everything, it seems. It's an uneven chess game, this world. Anyway, well, it's not really. But people decide purely on the, to make it